I said, what's up, y'all? Look at me when I'm talking to you, bro. Nah, I'm just messing with y'all, man. This your boy, Knockout Boxing 86 TV, and we in here. So check this out, bro. Before I get going on our video, smash the like button, subscribe to my channel if you're new here, share the video, turn on your notifications, and go follow me on Twitter, at KO Boxing 86 TV. If you have a breakdown or a prediction that you'd like me to do for you, knockoutboxing86@yahoo.com is the email address. And don't forget about our live shows. We're live every Wednesday and Thursday night, 7:30 p.m. Central Time. We're also live every Sunday morning with the singing OG, KQKC Boxing Network, Sunday mornings, 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. But let's go ahead and get it popping. Let's get into our video. And today, we got to talk about Steven Espinoza's updates that he gave on both the Errol Spence-Terrence Crawford negotiations and the Gervonta Davis-Ryan Garcia negotiations. I thought it was all pretty positive. I thought it was realistic. Some people are choosing to criticize Steven Espinoza today, and I don't understand why. So as far as Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence, look, he shot down Floyd Mayweather's notion that the fight can't happen right now, but it's going to happen in the future. He says it can happen now. He says it realistically could happen in December. And he said something interesting about they don't need time to promote a fight of this magnitude like they used to, because I thought the interviewer did a great job about asking him a question about, well, hey, is the fight going to, can it happen in December if you guys don't have as much time to promote it? He said for a fight of this magnitude, 6 weeks, 8 weeks, that's really all they need to promote a fight like this. And he brought up technology and how the digital age that we're in, you can get the information to the fans much quicker via social media. You can get it to them much quicker on the TV now with all the streaming services and things of that nature. So they don't need as much time. They don't need 3, 4, 5 months of press tour, all of that stuff. He feels like six weeks could be enough, which to me is something that's very, very good. He said the fight is very close. They want to make sure that everybody gets what they want. And all kind of positive vibes from him as it pertains to Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford. He said he's not blaming Terrence Crawford. He's not blaming any one side. The deal is complicated. A deal of this magnitude, a fight of this magnitude, they want to make sure that everybody's happy and that even if it's not November 19th, he can still see the fight happening, hopefully, before the end of the year. So I thought that was great news from somebody that's in the room, somebody that who is the leader of the network that is putting on the show. I thought that was very, very good news and very, very positive from Steven Espinoza. Now, they also asked him about Ryan Garcia and Gervonta Tank Davis. He said he wants to make that fight. The teams are talking. He knows that both fighters want the fight. However, the DAZN part, bro, the DAZN part is what I told y'all it was. It's a non-starter. It is going to kill the fight. If Ryan Garcia's team continues to insist that DAZN somehow be part of the broadcast, that DAZN somehow be part of the promotion or participate in this fight in any way, shape, or form, then they're probably not going to be able to make the fight because Steven Espinoza doesn't see a need for DAZN. And I must admit, neither do I. Now, I know people want to talk about fair. The only thing that the fair is good for here in Texas is fried food, fried Twinkies and fried Oreos and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? Fried lemonade. They even got fried butter at the fair. You fry everything here in Texas at the state fair. But that's the only thing that the fair is good for. Fair when it comes to these business negotiations, it's just not, it makes no sense. There's a side that argues that Ryan Garcia is a big name too. There's a side that argues that Ryan Garcia was built by DAZN and DAZN had him on their network, and now in the biggest fight, it's only right, it's only fair that they also get to broadcast the fight. I would just say you should have built him up better. You should have made him somebody that you can bring to the table and negotiate in a way to where it does warrant a co-promotional, co-network type of deal. But you, just the fact of the matter is this, bro. Tank Davis is breaking attendance records for boxing events at venues. Tank Davis has been fighting on pay-per-view without Ryan Garcia for his last three fights. And Ryan Garcia, on the other hand, has pulled out of multiple fights, has never been on pay-per-view, has never done the live gate numbers and broke the type of records and had the type of attendance and live gate revenue that Tank Davis has had. He is the clear cut, no matter what his fans will tell you, no matter what Tank Davis haters will tell you, no matter what anyone will tell you, he is the clear cut B-side, regardless of how many Instagram followers he has, regardless of how many people follow him on Twitter. Between him and Gervonta Tank Davis, there is one guy that's been on pay-per-view consistently while the other one hasn't. There is one guy that has sold out venues consistently while the other guy has not, bro. Like, it's just not, it's not even close. And we've seen this from Golden Boy Promotions, who promotes Ryan Garcia. We've seen this from them before. They just killed the Jermall Charlo and Jaime Munguia fight with some of the same demands. They just killed that fight with some of the same demands, and then they put it on the other side. They demanded that DAZN be a part of the broadcast for Showtime. I mean, for Jermall Charlo and Jaime Munguia. And now, based on what Stephen Espinosa is saying, they're doing it again. They are demanding that Ryan Garcia and his network that he's been fighting on, his app that he's been fighting on, DAZN, they're demanding that DAZN be part of the broadcast. And it's just not, for as big as the fight is at the lighter weights, the revenue does not dictate that it should be a co-network fight, bro. It just doesn't. Neither does it for Jermall Charlo and Jaime Munguia. You can't bring so little to the table in terms of what you've done before and then ask somebody who built up their fighter better. Just call it what it is. Tank Davis has actually been a world champion before. Tank Davis has fought far better competition than Ryan Garcia. Tank Davis is much more established than Ryan Garcia. Much more people go to Tank Davis's fights than they do to Ryan Garcia. People actually pay not only to go to Tank's fights, but they pay to watch him on TV. People pay for the $19.99 DAZN package, whether Ryan Garcia is on it or not. Conor Benn was about to fight on pay-per-view. Ryan Garcia has never fought on pay-per-view. Canelo is fighting on pay-per-view on DAZN. Ryan Garcia's last fight was not on pay-per-view. It just is what it is, bro. And so when you know that going into a negotiation and you ask for some shit like that anyway, then you're showing that by default you don't want the fight. You're showing that you don't want the fight. There's a great channel here on YouTube, Blue Blood Sports TV. If Blue Blood and I agree to debate, but Blue Blood tells me, look, Knockout, I will debate you, but you got to come to my channel because I'm the bigger channel. I generate more views than you. I generate more revenue for my channel than you, and more eyes will be on the debate if we debate. More eyes will be on the debate if it's on my platform because I'm more equipped because of what I built up over the years, Knockout. I'm more equipped to you than you are to host the debate because I will get us better views. I will get us the better chance of generating more revenue. What I look like telling him, nah, my platform got to be a part of it too. We got to broadcast it through my platform as well. What I look like telling him that? If I haven't built up to the level that he's built himself up to. That's basically all this shit is, bro. What does Ryan Garcia, Oscar De La Hoya, and the Golden Boy side look like demanding that DAZN be able to broadcast this fight just as much as Showtime when Showtime has built Tank Davis into a much better commodity than Ryan Garcia has been built into? If you're Oscar De La Hoya and you really want this fight for your fighter, you go ahead, take your promoter percentage, and you let your fighter go over there and fight Tank Davis if you believe in your fighter. If you Oscar De La Hoya, you take your promoter percentage from Jaime Munguia, and you let Jaime Munguia go over there and fight for a world championship against Jermall Charlo. You don't demand things that you know the other side is unlikely to agree to. That's killing the negotiations before they even start. Because you can negotiate on everything else and agree to everything else, but you still got this non-starter over here that you're not coming up off of. It makes no sense as to why a fight fan that truly wants to fight can see all of this and then somehow blame Stephen Espinosa or blame Showtime or PBC or Tank Davis when it's clearly Ryan Garcia and his team is holding up the fight. with these demands that no one will ever agree to when they're the clear-cut A-side. You not telling Floyd Mayweather, Oscar De La Hoya when he was the man, Canelo Alvarez right now, Errol Spence right now at welterweight, and Tank Davis right now at the lighter weights, 140, 135, and 130. You're not telling them what network to fight on. You're not bullying them into allowing you and your network to broadcast their fights. They have made it to the point. They have generated enough revenue. They have all made themselves A-side enough. Errol Spence, Tank Davis, Canelo Alvarez, right? Anthony Joshua, these active fighters right now. Deontay Wilder when he's fighting anyone but Anthony Joshua. These guys have built themselves up enough to where if you want to fight them, you fight them on their network. Asking for anything else is showing that you really don't want the fight. Point blank period. Tell me where I'm wrong. But anyway, y'all let me know what y'all think, man. Comment down below. Smash the like. Subscribe to the channel. Share the video. Turn on your notifications. Follow me on Twitter at KOBoxing86TV. For breakdowns and predictions, KnockoutBoxing86@Yahoo.com is the email. I appreciate y'all watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. And with that, we up out of here. Peace out, y'all.